Eurogold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
Vita is an award-winning, independently run Italian restaurant. Located on Rose Lane in the heart of Liverpool, real Italian-style dishes, using the best ingredients, skillfully prepared by our chefs. Come and try our serious Italian experience.
Supreme Upholstery Limited is a manufacturer of quality bespoke upholstered furniture. Come along with your ideas for that perfect sofa to fit your home and let Supreme bring your ideas to fruition. We also offer a service to the contract market, including large hotel groups and small family-run business. No matter how large or how small your order, you will always get that personal service from our sales team. Come along and visit our showroom.
Hello everyone and welcome to the show. This week we're coming to you from Craic by the Craic Festival in Romley, Cheshire. It's the first festival for 18 months. We've got a really exciting show lined up for you. We hope you enjoy it. But first, I'm going to take you on a little tour around this beautiful venue.
On the banks of the roses, we love a nice sit down. The night took out me fiddle for the play, we love a tune. In the middle of the tune, oh, she sighed and she said, oh, Johnny, lovely Johnny, don't you leave me. And then I am no runaway, and soon I let them know that I can take a bottle or can leave it alone. If her daddy doesn't like it, he can keep his daughter home, and young Johnny will grow them with some other.
Joe, you just come off stage there. My goodness, the crowd loved you, didn't they?
We had a lot of fun then, Martin. Yeah, a lot of fun.
You were just like a man that was let loose from somewhere in the wild.
Well, after being caged up for so long, what can you expect? It was, goodness me, I can't describe how good it feels to be back and playing. Honestly, it's the best feeling in the world.
Now, I have to say, you and your band, what a great performance you put on. Honest to God, the crowd really loved it.
Yeah, well, to be honest, Martin, we always enjoy ourselves, but this was extra special. Like I said, being in front of 2,500 people, screaming back the Irish songs, goosebumps all the way through. Yeah.
great atmosphere. But of course, how's things been for you? Have you been in the recording studio? Where are you up to with things now, Joe?
Yeah, well, I mean, we've not been able to play for a very long time, so we've used the time. We've been writing a load of music, and we've been recording. We were down in Abbey Road not too long ago, actually, recording with a fella called David Coyle, who's originally a Derry man, and he's over here now producing our music, which is great. And we've got new singles coming out in the very near future, so yeah, keep an eye out.
It's really good, honestly, and everybody loves it now. It's great to be out here, and of course, what a lovely, lovely venue.
It's unbelievable. I've never been here before, but we were just talking about the drive-in. It's absolutely gorgeous here. I've got to say a huge thanks to Matt and Donal for getting us down to play the festival. You know, they put an awful lot of hard work and effort into the festival, and they've made a special event now. People are going to be talking about this for a long time.
Tell us about bookings. How can people book you, Joe? You know, there's venues opening now up and down the country.
you can always get in touch with me. Email me, joe@joekeegan.co.uk. We'd love to play anything. We're really, really, like I said, excited to get back and playing. And can't wait to get as many bookings as we can in the diary. You know, it's looking good. You know, things are coming back slowly. So it's it's good to be back playing, like I said. I can't tell you how good that is.
Sing a good time, girls, won't you come out tonight? Come out tonight, come out tonight. Good time, girls, won't you come out tonight? We dance by the light of the moon. Hey! You know, I danced with a dolly with a hole in a stocking and knees. Kept knocking, band was a rocking.
First gig in 18 months, Martin. Delighted to be here. And the lads, Matt, Donal, Patrick, they've worked their bottoms off, should we say, to make this festival possible. It's an amazing success, completely sold out, 3,000 people here or so, and great to see gigs eventually happening after so long, you know.
Absolutely. Joe Keegan and his band is on there. We can hear them in the background, and the crowd is really up for this one.
They're really, really excited. Like, even seeing the people walking up, they've travelled from all over Ireland, from England. There's Scottish people there, all over the place. Just amazing atmosphere, and people getting out just to enjoy themselves once again, you know.
Is this your first real gig now since the lockdown?
Yeah, since February of 2020. 18 months ago, I think it is, really, 17, 18 months since I've done a gig. So tonight I have a lot of lyrics written on the floor, so I try and remember all the words to the songs, you know.
But of course you've got quite a few gigs starting to come up now. The bookings are gradually picking up.
At last, yeah, we're going to be able to do gigs, which we should have done last year. We put them off too early this year, and then they got moved again to later this year. So in September, October, November, we're coming back on tour to England, taking in venues in Manchester and Liverpool and Birmingham. London Palladium is the start of next year. Can't wait to get going again with a proper tour. I suppose my last single was in memory of our good friend Nicky James, which we've spoken about a good few times, and that song was called Wings to Fly, so that did very well for us and got a lot of radio play, and a lot of people contacted me who'd lost a friend and family, and they related to the song as well, which as a songwriter you couldn't ask for any more, you know, than people connecting with the song, you know, so I was glad about that.
Absolutely, and of course the BBC got involved in that as well, and I know that you're raising money for the Alderhay Children's Hospital.
Yeah, through the power of the song, really, they heard that and they got in contact, and then we sent a few emails, and then I've now became an ambassador for the Children's Hospital in Liverpool Alderhay, which is a fantastic place. They do amazing work with a lot of sick children.
Congratulations on being an ambassador for the hospital. It's a really special award, that. And I know you're waiting to go on stage now, Nathan, so you want to go on there, you want to entertain the crowd. We're all ready to listen to you.
Thanks very much, and well done to you, all the gang behind the scenes. This festival is hopefully the start of many more things to come, you know, and all I can do is wish them all the best, and hopefully we have a fantastic night tonight on stage.
As I was walking down the street, down the street, down the street, a pretty little girl I chanced to meet. We danced by the light of the moon. You know, I danced with a dolly with a hole in a stocking and knees kept knocking. Band was rocking. I danced with a dolly with a hole.
Alan, of course, you're the main man here this weekend because of the Master of Ceremonies, and you've got to get everybody on stage on time.
Yeah, well, it's a great privilege, Martin, as you know. I mean, I've been doing this for many, many years, and it brings me back to the Pontins Irish Festival. You know, they started that in Prestatyn. My voice is going hoarse because we've been shouting and screaming already. But they started that in the early days. They had Daniel O'Donnell, and then it got that big that the following year they had to move it to Southport. And I can see this festival, you know, Craic by the Creek, it is a bit special. It's got that feel, and you've got the next generation coming through. So already the atmosphere is amazing.
And you've got a great lineup of music as well.
Great lineup of music. We've got international stars, Nathan Carter, obviously Lisa McHugh, you know, all folked up. The list is endless. But then where I think the organisers, you know, Matt and Donal and Patrick, where I think they've got it right, they've got some of the local talent as well. So they've gone right across the board. It's something for everybody, Martin, and that's what the secret of the success of this will be.
Tell me about the venue.
Well, the venue is based in East Cheshire, on the south side of Stockport, near Romilly, for anybody who's got the geographic sort of awareness. It's a wonderful venue. It does do many other festivals. So Carl and all his team here, who own the farm and own the land, they're very, very, very familiar with these sort of festivals. They've got it well organised. They know how to do it. And I think that the three boys who are part of this project, they've fallen well with Carl, and he's guided them. But they put the hard work in, and they've got the numbers in the crowd which are here.
Now, of course, your face is very well known down there at Old Trafford and on the TV all the time. And of course, we're changing it now from music to football. But great news about Manchester United today.
Yeah, well, they've got the signing over the line, you know, with Jadon. That's the main thing. And, you know, there's been a lot of publicity with the media. And before the Euros, was he, wasn't he, was he going to sign? It's been announced now, so a great acquisition for United. He'll add a lot to that right-hand wing, and he'll get some supply into, hopefully, Mason Greenwood or Cavani, whoever's there. And maybe one more signing, Varane. We get him, then we might be able to have a go at the title, Martin.
How are you enjoying your time at United, Alan?
It's going absolutely fantastic. I mean, I can't believe it's 21 seasons. It's just been absolutely incredible. I started in 2000, and next to your job, it's the best in the world.
Alan, great to see you, mate. All the best. God bless you.
Thank you very much, Martin. Well done to you and Annette for keeping the flag flying.
Hi, Martin. Yeah, we're having a great time. This is our second day. It's beautiful. It's great. It's a really family event. Fantastic. Well run and brilliant.
Did you enjoy Nathan Carter last night?
Oh, he was unreal. He was so good. Brilliant. He got the crowd going, everyone back, happy, hugging, loving. Great time. Thank you so much, Nathan.
Lovely. And I believe we're all coming to your house later on for tea.
Well, why not? Yes, why not? Everyone go back for the after party.
But you're just around the corner, aren't you? We know where you are now.
Just over the hill.
Lovely. Now, what have you enjoyed about this weekend?
We've only literally just got here, but everything, it's just so amazing. The people and the dancing and the bands and the alcohol.
And of course the crowd, they are all up for all the music today.
Everyone's up for the music, and there's so much talent out there. It's great, and I hope it enriches every year to come. It's the best thing that's happened to Cheshire in a long time.
Tell me, what part of Armagh are you from?
South Armagh. My club is Dorsey Emmets, so I'm from around the region of Cross and Glen. So hello to everyone back home. Thank you very much.
Lovely. Well, lovely to meet you all. Enjoy the festival.
On the banks of the roses, me love and I sit down. The light to God me fiddle for to play me love a tune. In the middle of a tune, oh, she sighed and she said, oh, Johnny, lovely Johnny, don't you leave.
We're all having a great day here at the festival, enjoying the music, the sunshine. We hope you are at home. See you in a few minutes.
Euro Gold is driven by being the best civil engineering contractor in the Northwest, ensuring its clients are given the highest level of service that they deserve. Eurogold work in a wide range of industry sectors, including house building, highways, commercial and industrial build.
Lolla Vita is an award-winning, independently run Italian restaurant. Located on Rose Lane in the heart of Liverpool, real Italian-style dishes, using the best ingredients, skillfully prepared by our chefs. Come and try our serious Italian experience.
Supreme Upholstery Limited is a manufacturer of quality bespoke upholstered furniture. Come along with your ideas for that perfect sofa to fit your home and let Supreme bring your ideas to fruition. We also offer a service to the contract market, including large hotel groups and small family-run business. No matter how large or how small your order, you will always get that personal service from our sales team. Come along and visit our showroom.
Welcome back. We are having a fantastic time here at the Craic by the Craic Festival in the beautiful Cheshire countryside. And I've been joined by the three organisers, that's Donald Scally, Matt Kelly and Patrick Brennan. Donald, you must be so, so happy with the way things have gone.
Oh, yeah, delighted. Everyone's having a great time by the looks of it. And everyone's saying this needs to be every year because it's so good. So that's making us happy anyway.
Yeah, and of course you just come off stage yourselves there now, and Matt and the rest of the band, and you've got a great performance out there.
Oh yeah, we thought we'd put ourselves on the big stage, and yeah, everyone seemed to enjoy it, and it was good to play with the five-piece band on the big stage, so yeah.
And your opening night, Matt, was just absolutely fantastic.
It was amazing, the turnout was incredible. Obviously we sort of had an idea of how many people were coming, but to see it, especially after the past year or two, to see everyone together, it's been great. Everyone's had a great time. Seeing people they've not seen for ages, it's been great.
You've had a fantastic lineup of music all over the weekend.
We have Nathan Carter, Lee from Kew Warfolk Top. All the bands that have played have been amazing, and still some playing tomorrow. It's been great. They're going to be great tomorrow as well.
Patrick, you lads have worked so hard over the last 2 years. We know last year was cancelled on you, but my goodness, this year you've really pulled it out.
Yeah, we really have worked hard, and we've had massive ups and downs. Real problems along the way, as some people might know, but you know what, we've carried on and keep going, and we've created far better than we set out for, and every person out there is just blown away by it, and we just thank everyone for coming and supporting us.
Isn't it lovely to see so many people here today, families, individuals, everybody is here having a lovely, lovely time.
Yeah, well, we cater from everyone from 8 months old to 88 years old. Everyone's out there having a good time, having a party. We cater for everyone and everyone seems to be loving it.
And you couldn't have picked a better venue.
No, we always said, we talked about this for a while, we wanted to do a festival, but we said we wouldn't do it until we found the right venue for it. And then Matt and myself were playing here at a wedding gig, and we came, Buckle and Boots Festival, another festival they do here, we came to that and we just said, right, this place is great, it's got the infrastructure already. And then we got to know the farmer who owns the place, Carl, who's been brilliant, and Gary and all the team. And they've been like mentors to us. They've helped us along and, you know, taught us a lot, which is good.
The question everybody's asking, Matt, is will you be having one next year?
That's the plan, I think. Not really got past this year yet, but potentially, I mean, there's loads of people to thank, all the sponsors, all the bands, all the public for sticking with us over the year as well. Let's see what happens on Monday.
And of course, look at... You've had a great setup here. There's been so much going on. You've had camping, glamping, you've had food, you've had drink, you've had absolutely everything.
Yeah, we tried to tick every box, and I think we've done a pretty good job. Nobody seems to have any complaints. Everyone just wants it back next year.
Okay, lads, well done. Congratulations. Great success for you all. Well done. Well, you never know who you're going to bump into at a festival like this. I've just met Joe McShane. Hello, Joe.
Martin, how are you doing? Nice to see you.
Oh, lovely to see you.
I should have called you that I was coming over.
What a surprise. You're welcome.
Oh, well, thank you. Thank you very much. What a festival.
Yeah.
Oh, geez. It's great. Unbelievable.
Absolutely.
Oh, bye.
And the weather was good as well. It made it for everybody.
It sure did, yeah. Yeah. The weather was great. I just come over 2 days ago. So I'm in Manchester tomorrow night, actually, on Sunday, and the following Sunday.
Tell us where you live these days.
Silverbridge, South Armagh.
So you're back doing gigs now, and you're here in Manchester for a few gigs.
Yeah, and anybody wants to know, I'm here if you want to book me. I'm about.
How can they do that?
You get me on Facebook there, Joe McShane. I'm up there on the internet.
See you again, Joe.
Martin, thank you so much. Okay. It's great to see you.
I feel like I'm dreaming to be actually somewhere that's not Enniskillen in Ireland.
Well, I can honestly say we haven't seen you performing at any festivals for the last 18 months.
I know. It's been a long 18 months, to be honest, but we are just so excited to get back on stage. And the atmosphere, as you can probably hear, is really building here in Manchester, so I can't wait to get up and start singing again.
It is, and there's a big crowd now waiting for you to go on stage there, and they're all in great form.
Well, hopefully they're going to have a good time, fingers crossed.
Yeah. Now, tell me a little bit about, I know the 18 months has been a hard time for all you guys and everything, but you've released some songs during that time. Tell me about your music.
Yeah, I've released a few of my singles over the last 18 months. We did plan on doing some tours and things and releasing an album as well as that, but COVID got in the way of a lot of plans, and we had to kind of, you know, stall things a little bit. But I still got to release some of my own music, some of my own material from my new coming album, and it's got a fantastic reaction so far. So this is the first time I'm going to get to perform them in front of a live audience tonight, so I'm really excited to see what they like.
It wasn't all done over the last 18 months, because I believe you got engaged as well. Many congratulations.
Oh, thank you so much. I did indeed, yes. I got engaged last July, so it's mad to believe that it was a year ago already. It's flown by, so fingers crossed we'll get to have our wedding very, very soon.
And everybody will want to know about this wonderful man that you've found.
Well, he's not in the business, he's kind of shy, he likes to keep himself to himself, so that's also what I love about it as well, because it's out of the music business, it's out of the showbiz, and it's very separate to what I do every single day. So it's got...
Now, the other thing you've done, you've achieved a lifetime achievement as well, because you've started your own radio show on Downtown Radio. Tell me about that.
I started in March my very own show on Downtown Radio every Saturday afternoon from 4 until 7, and since then, I've had an absolute ball. I've always wanted to do radio or TV presenting. So when Downtown gave me the opportunity, I absolutely jumped at the chance, and I've loved it ever since.
We're all looking forward to seeing you back on stage, Lisa. Anne-Marie, you must be a very proud mum. Your son, of course, is one of the organisers, Matt Kelly.
Absolutely proud. They've worked so hard for this, and it's just all come to fruition. It's absolutely wonderful. So proud of the work they've done, everything they've put into it. Just been amazing, and so many obstacles along the way as well. You know, and they've just overcome all of them, and it's just an amazing day. Amazing artists, yeah.
Well, this time last year, we just thought it's not meant to be, you know, with the virus, it was cancelled and everything. But here we come, we bounce back, and we're bigger and better than ever.
It's absolutely, it's twice as good. It was only originally going to be the one day, and now we've got three whole days of the festival, and it's absolutely packed. Great crowds, and the musicians, everything about it, it's just amazing.
I know you enjoyed it, but there was no need to go and tumble on your foot and break your leg, was there? How did that happen?
Well, I had to give Matthew a kick up the backside.
Anyway, how are you managing? Is it painful?
No, I'm managing. Nothing stops me. Nothing to keep a Kelly down.
And of course, Lynn, we're all absolutely thrilled to meet so many of our friends here today.
Absolutely, and that's what we were just saying before, like, the whole apprehension of coming back out. And people are apprehensive, like, they've not seen people for a long time and coming back into social environments. But the fundamental part that I've seen is it's so amazing to actually see people that you haven't seen and reconnect with people and enjoy their company in an outdoor environment, safe environment, and an enjoyable position.
Of course, it's been a hard time for everybody, but of course it's been a hard time for the associations as well. And you, as chairperson of the Roscommon Association, you know, how do you see things going forward?
Absolutely, and I mean, it's going to be a challenge to get people back out and to re-engage with socialising, especially, unfortunately, like some people are more reserved on the older side as well. And hopefully, small steps and maybe with smaller functions in time, people will be more confident to re-engage in that environment.
And we hope for that. And Dominic, of course, your pub O'Shea has played a big part in keeping people's spirits up over the last couple of months. You had a wonderful outdoor arena.
Well, of course, Martin, we sort of came up with the idea to open the outdoor bar. O'Shea's doesn't have a beer garden. Restrictions, of course, the government restrictions stopped everybody socialising in a different way. We want to give people a safe environment. We did do that. I think the most satisfying thing for us was bringing musicians, door staff, people that hadn't worked for a year and a half, and to see them coming back to work was amazing. It was just absolutely amazing. There was a lot of tears and emotion the first day we opened, bringing people back to life, and it's been a hard year for everybody, never mind publicans, but the people associated with our trade as well.
A wonderful time here at Craic by the Creek Festival. The weather has been fantastic, the music has been sensational, and we've all enjoyed it. We hope you've enjoyed the show at home, and many congratulations to the organisers that have done a fantastic job. Now don't forget, Henry McGlade is back with his show next Thursday evening from County Mayo, and we are here as usual every Thursday night, 7:30, the Irish in the UK. See you next week.